गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर कॉलेज आई ज्योति ढांडके एंड माय कोऑर्डिनेटर संस्कार मस्के वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस वेबिनार. ड्यू टू COVID-19 लॉकडाउन ऑनलाइन वेबिनार्स ऑनलाइन FDPs हैव बीन द प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर पीपल कैन कम एंड डिस्कस एंड रीच ईच अदर. The goal of this webinar is how one can develop the interest in mathematics. Once learners can understand how to speak the language of mathematics, communicating their ideas will be a lot easier for them. When learners face challenging problems, we don't want them to give up. Through this webinar, we want them to make connections, think creatively and try different avenues towards easy solutions. The goal of this webinar is to guide all learners to become highly capable problem solvers in non-routine situations and prepare for future success. Thank you, all of you.
Good morning, everyone. This is Abhishek talking to you from Leuven, Belgium. This has been an honor to speak in this small webinar arranged by Bharatiya Vidyapeth. And this program, as I was told, that we should talk about tracing solution curves. Being a non-mathematician, so I come from a background of engineering. I did my chemical engineering in India, and then I went to Belgium in 2006. I did my chemical engineering PhD in the University of Ghent from 2006, and then I finished my PhD, continued my postdoctoral studies also in mathematical related engineering, which is biomath. We call it biomath here. And then I started teaching at the University of Leuven since 2006. And after that, recently I took a break from KU Leuven. I joined University Catholic de Louvain, so that's UCL. And in this university, I'm engaged as a researcher. And then, of course, I have a little small consulting firm of my own, which is called Simuligence. And in that company, I am working with artificial intelligence-based simulations, whereby I try to predict some interesting phenomena for my clients through modeling approach. Okay, coming back to the topic of today's discussion, we are talking about tracing solution curves. Tracing solution curves are a very necessary aspect of mathematical engineering. And typically, the solution curves are applied for nonlinear equations. As you know that most of the linear equations are virtually non-existent for complex problems of nature. So we have nonlinear equations, and these nonlinear equations need to be handled through this tracing of solution curves. Typically, this approach is used for nonlinear equations, as I just mentioned to you. And this has been a very widely applied application problem that has been encountered in science and technology. So coming back to a little bit of a more interesting part of what a solution curve is, as you know that as a computational method, this tracing of solution curves, there are several methods that are available. And where these methods are used, for example, this method can be used in tracing solution curves of systems of nonlinear equations, and these nonlinear equations typically are of the form of f1 of x1, x2, x3 till dot up till xn plus 1 equals 0, up till f1, f2, f3, and it goes on till fn. So we have x1 values that change from 1 to n or rather n plus 1, and f1, the function that goes from f1 till n, f of n. This system of nonlinear equations, as I was just telling to you, this can be solved using the tracing the solution curves, and one efficient algorithm to handle this solution curve is the so-called predictor corrector method. This predictor corrector method is not a very new topic. This topic has been widely discussed and they have been widely used in the past. So there is nothing new in this, but it's a very efficient algorithm to solve solution curve. Typically, this predictor corrector method consists of two steps. As you have seen with the name, there is a predictor and there is a corrector. So the method consists of a succession of the predictor step and the corrector step. So there's a succession of predictor step and the corrector step. What happens is that in the predictor step, we predict the next point, which is farther along the solution curve. So we predict the next point, which is further along the solution curve. And in the corrector step, so that's a subsequent step of this predictor curve. In the corrector step, we get back onto the solution curve by some iterative method, which we started from the predictor point. So that's basically a kind of like an iterative method. You can say it's an iterative algorithm to solve this kind of problem. And it's a very efficient algorithm. It's a very efficient algorithm because you first guess and then you come back and you track it and again you correct it yourself. So predict and correct. This whole thing converges to a point. This predictor corrector method, if done together, when done together, it converges to a point on the same curve as a previous point. So that's the beauty of this. That's the simplicity of this method. There are problems whereby this predictor corrector method is not very efficient, and this has been an issue for example by unavoiding small step sizes and similar. So the whole problem, as you can see, if it's a predictor corrector method, so it needs to predict the steps further, but if the step is large, is quite big, then the whole prediction can be wrong, and then the correction can be equally faulted as well. So there are some disadvantages of this method, and for that we know that we have to take small step sizes and similar. So these are the problems or the challenges that come in this predictor corrector method, and for that, of course, there are some modified algorithms that has been developed for handling this shortcoming. So in the next program, when I'll be talking a little bit more on this predictor corrector method, I wish this to happen in a couple of months' time from now. I'll be able to explain to you all how to solve this kind of disadvantages in predictor corrector method. It's a very easy and very simplified method, but it has to be handled very, very correctly in order to trace the solution curve. Thank you very much. It was a very short video from my side because of lockdown challenges. Yeah. I will come back to you in couple of months' time with a more clear and efficient explanation of how to solve this solution curve without its disadvantages. Thank you very much and stay safe.
Thank you, sir, for giving us your valuable time. Now I request our technical team to switch the display to Professor Jyoti Dhanke, and she will brush up the whole tracing of curve topic. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
In this presentation, we would be introducing tracing of curve with examples and its problem solution. Comprehending completed problems in similar fashion is the motive of this webinar. Mathematics becomes easy when problems are solved using different techniques. Curve tracing is the process of determining the shape, location, singular points, and other characteristics of a curve from its equation. Actually, curve tracing, that is the techniques that can be used to produce a rough idea of overall shape of curve given its equation without computing the large number of points. Here I have taken some examples of curve like lemniscate, estroid, polar curves, chordioids. In the polar curves, there are particular some rose curves which are comparing them with familiar shapes. This like this lemniscate comparing with infinity. This is the familiar figure. Asteroid is comparing with kite. This is also familiar shape. Here is chordioids. Chordioid. This is the compare with familiar shape. That is heart shape. So chordioid is comparing with heart shape. And polar curve is there. There is particular polar shape. That is rose curve. So rose curve is comparing with familiar shape, that is rose flower. Okay, so here these are the particulars, these types I am comparing with the familiar shapes. Here lemniscate, this, if there is the in mathematical language, you trace the curve for lemniscate, r square equal to a square sine to theta. But if we compare with familiar shape, that is the symbol of infinity, draw the symbol of infinity. And here what will be the question? Trace the curve of lemniscate. So here is the mathematical language, lemniscate. But if we consider in the familiar language, we draw the symbol of infinity. So these are the very simpler method also there is available. If there is the question like this, okay, if there is this question, trace the curve for asteroid. Which asteroid? X raised to 2 raised to 3 plus Y raised to 2 raised to 3 equal to A raised to 2 raised to 3. So this asteroid, again I am comparing with kite shape. Here is the draw kite shape. So this asteroid is, I am comparing with familiar language, kite shape. Draw the shape of kite. Okay, so this is the shape of kite, and here is, I am showing that is the infinity. So if the question type, asking question is type is differentiate like this, if lemniscate, and if you are asking here, draw the symbol of infinity. So this make the easy to understand. If there is a question, asteroid, trace the curve for asteroid. And if we ask the question, draw kite shape, and with the some conditions like this, we satisfy this type of conditions. So again, this going to understand very easy. Similarly, the next type is, if there is question is asking like this, trace the curve for chordioid. And there are four chordioids, r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta, r equal to a into 1 minus cos theta, r equal to a into 1 plus sine theta, r equal to a into 1 minus sine theta. So these four chordioids, if there is the familiar language, you draw heart shapes. So this going to understand easy, or with the, because this is the familiar shape. So if the technique, just we have to change small change or to explanation with the to students or any other branch faculties. So this becomes very easy. Okay, this chordioids is not a difficult. But if we ask like this, draw heart shape, and also this becomes easy. This is a familiar shape. Okay. And these are the four chordioids. Okay. And the next is, example is the, if there is trace any polar curve. Trace any polar curve means where we are using the polar coordinates, r and theta. So here particular example I am considering, that is rose curve. So here question is, trace any polar curve which is rose curve. And this question, if I am asking like this, in familiar language, in familiar shape, draw a flower, that is rose flower. So here we have to trace rose curve, and here we have to draw rose flower. So here we are tracing the two curves r equal to a cos 2 theta, and second one is r equal to a sin 2 theta. First is r equal to a cos theta, this is, and r equal to a sin 2 theta, this is. So now we are going to discuss this two, how to trace these rose curves, how to trace these rose flowers. So if the question pattern is like this and is like this, so if also the question thinking is different, then solution thinking all becomes easy also. For if we thinking like this, if we think like this, becomes maybe slightly difficult. But if the question asking like this, and if we going to understand like this, he draw a flower, which is a particular flower, rose flower, so it becomes very easy. Now we go to discuss this particular, these two rose curves. So one by one we have to discuss, and first we have to discuss the methods. So next is so here we are going to discuss these methods, steps here to trace the polar curves, which is particular polar curve means rose curve. So in polar curves there is r and theta polar coordinates we are using. That's why these are the polar equations, polar curves. We have to trace these two curves. So if we think about like this, if we have to trace, if we have to draw rose curve, if we have to draw the rose curve, so rose curves, if we want to draw, so we want to draw petals, we want to draw the lines, these petals we draw on the lines. So what we think here, how many lines are there? How many petals are there, and what is the distance between the petals? If you are thinking about the question is easy, then obviously solution becomes easy if you are thinking like the question. So if what we are drawing here, if we are thinking about the rose, if we are drawing here rose flower, so what we have to think? We have to think about the petals, and these petals on which line, and what is the distance between the petals. So we are thinking about the rose flower, and here we solving this question, tracing of this polar curve means tracing of the rose curve. Okay, so now here we clear the concept. If we think about this, tracing the rose flower. So tracing the rose flower. So here first we required the petals and also the lines. So here step by step we have to find. First we have to find the number of lines. So in the equation. There is in the equation, if r equal to a cos n theta, r equal to a sin n theta. This is the particular type for rose curve. Rose curve is we are considering rose flower. So here this is the particular type. Is this n? And r equal to a cos n theta, r equal to a sin n theta. So how many lines, how many petals? So first we have to find the number of lines. So step one, we have to find the number of lines in each quadrant. In each quadrant, that is, we denoted by QL. This is n minus 1. N, this is given in the question. This is given in the equation of the curve. So how to find the number of lines in each quadrant? So in there, we know there are four quadrants. So in each quadrant, how many lines we have to draw, and then we draw the petals, means in the tracing of the curve, in the bookish language, there we use the loops, but in the familiar language, we use the number of petals. So just we are changing the language, or so just we changing the understanding, which is better to understand. Okay, so step one, what is the step one? Okay, first you have to find number of lines in each quadrant. We have four quadrants. So first we find the number of lines in each quadrant, that is n minus 1. This is the step one. Now this lines we obtained, okay, number of lines we obtained, then we have to draw these lines in each quadrant. But these are near, or these are, what is the distance between this line, what is the angle between these lines in each quadrant? So that's why first you have to find the angle. Now we are going to find the angle between these above lines. Here these lines are n minus 1. So we obtained here lines. So what will be the angle between these lines? So what will be the angle between these lines? Including axis also, axis line, positive x-axis, positive y-axis, negative x, negative y-axis. So here in the step 2, we find the angle between above lines, including axis, by using this formula, theta is equal to pi by 2 upon n, which is given in the question. This is the n. Okay, so what is the angle between above lines? This is theta equal to pi by 2 by n. Now the step third. So here we obtained ki what number of lines and what is the distance between the lines, or what is the angle between these lines. This is pi by 2 upon n. Okay. Now these lines are clear. Number of lines are clear, and their distance. Their distance means angle between these lines are clear. Now the next is, now we are drawing rose curve. Okay, we are drawing rose curve. So rose curve first, now we discuss about the petals. Okay, how many petals are there, and where is the first petal, and then where are the next petals. So in the tracing of curve, we petals, we are telling here, it is denoted by LP, that is number of loops. So here we find the number of loops, means number of petals, how many petals in the rose flower. So here we are finding number of loops, that is 2n. When we use 2n, when we use n, if n is even, it is given in the question. If n is even, then number of loops are 2n. If n is odd, the number of loops is n. Okay, loops means the rose flowers. It's petals of the rose flower. So now we obtained here number of loops. How many loops are there? Now the tracing. Now we start the tracing. So how to start the tracing of these loops? So we start from the first loop. We start from the first loop. If r equal to a cos n theta. So on the each quadrant, if and also including lines, x-axis, y-axis or whatever. So initially, yeah, on the x-axis, the angle is theta equal to 0. Angle is theta equal to 0. This is theta equal to 0 line means x-axis. Theta equal to 0 line, that is x-axis. So if theta equal to 0, we put here and here. If theta equal to 0, if we put here, then cos 0, n into 0. This is cos 0. Cos 0 becomes 1. So r equal to a. So here we opted r equal to a. That means first loop is at the a distance from the origin. So first loop here we obtained on x axis theta equal to 0 because r equal to a. But if your equation is r equal to a sine n theta, then what is the change in the first loop? Okay, if r equal to a sine n theta, then first loop on the line which is next to theta equal to 0 line means for the sine here where we have to trace the first loop, that is on the next to theta equal to 0 line. Theta equal to 0 line means here loop on the line, that line will be next to x axis. After the next axis, this coming line will be the here line on which we have to trace the first loop. So here we discuss the first loop. Now we have to trace the remaining loops. Now first loop is clear. If cos, then first loop on the x axis means theta equal to 0 line. But if sine, then first loop on the line which is next to theta equal to 0 line. Okay, now we trace the remaining loops. Now we trace the remaining petals. So next loop on 4n upon lpth line. Next loop on 4n upon lpth line. So what is n, what is lp? N, that is given in the question. And what is LP? LP is the number of loops. Here we obtained in the previous step number of loops, LP. LP, it depends upon N, nature of N. If N is even, then number of loops is 2N. But if N is odd, then number of loops are N. So here 2N, number of loops are 2N. If N is even, if N is odd, then number of loops are n. Okay, so these are the four steps to tracing the rose curve. Rose curve means rose flower, petals are required and lines are required. So, how to find the lines? How many lines are there? And when, what is the distance between these lines? Means angle between the lines, pi by 2 upon n. Okay, these two things for the lines. And the, what about the loops? How many loops are there? And the where is the first loop position and where is the next loop positions? So these two steps defining the loops positions and number of loops. Right? And in the first and second steps showing the number of lines and angle between the lines. Okay, so these two steps for lines and these two steps for loops. Okay, isn't it? So now we solve some questions and using these steps. See here, trace the curve r equal to a cos 2 theta. So first we clear about this 2. What is here n? N is 2, which is the even number. So now we compare this with the rose curve, because the rose curve general equation is r equal to a cos n theta. This is the general equation of rose curve. So n equal to 2. So we have to trace the rose curve, means we have to first clear about the lines as well as the loops. So how many lines are there? What is the angle between the lines? How many loops are there? And where is first loop? Where are the next loops? Just these things we have to find. So now first we have to find the number of lines in each quadrant. How many quadrants are there? Four quadrants. First, second, third, fourth. These four quadrants. So how many lines in each quadrant to trace the rose curve? The number of lines in each quadrant, QL equal to n minus 1. That is, n is given in the question, that is 2. Then 2 minus 1, it becomes 1. So in each quadrant, number of lines that is 1. So in the first quadrant, this is one line. In each quadrant, we obtained this number of lines. In this quadrant, again one. In this quadrant, one line. In this quadrant, one line. So number of lines in each quadrant we obtained, that is n minus 1, is 2 minus 1 equal to 1. That's why we drawn here one line in each quadrant. So there are 4 quadrants, 4 lines we drawn. Now, what is the distance between these lines, or you can say, what is the angle between these lines? What is the angle between these lines, including the axis? So what is the formula for which we discuss in the step 2? Pi by 2 upon n. So pi by 2 upon n which is given in the question, that is 2. So pi by 2 upon 2 becomes pi by 4. Then what is the angle between the lines including axis? Pi by 4, that is 45 degree. 180. So here 45 degree. So see, including axis. So this is axis. Okay. So how to tracing these lines? Okay, this angle is pi by 4. Again, this line and axis angle is pi by 4. That means we are tracing like this. The angle should between them is pi by 4. Now again here in pi by 4. So we here take care ki where are the lines and what is the angle between the lines. Okay. So here we completed the step 1 and 2. We drawn the lines with the angles. Now we have to trace the loops. So loops means petals. So how many loops? How many petals? So here number of loops depends upon the n nature. And what is n? What is n? N is even number. N is 2. That is even number. If even number, then what is the formula? What was the formula here? If n is even, then 2n. If n is odd, then number of loops are n. So in this example, n is 2, which is even number. Which is even number. So this even number, how we use here, if number of loops here, if n is 2, then number of loops becomes 2 into n, that is 2 into 2, 4. Then how many loops will be there? 4. So here we have to trace the 4 loops. It means we have to trace here 4 petals. 4 petals in rose flower. So here number of loops, that is 2n, because n is even number. So number of loops are 4. So total loops means total petals we have to trace 4. So now we start to trace the loops. Now we start to trace the petals. So now we start from the first loop. So where is the first loop? The first loop on the angle theta equal to 0 line. Now we check where is the first loop on this axis or its next line. From where we have to start, because theta from here we are going to start theta equal to 0. Then theta here 45, then 90, then 135, then 180 are like this. Hai na? Then come to here theta equal to 360 degree. So how this theta is going to start from this direction, theta equal to 0. Okay. So from the according to this, you have to find the position of first loop. So we check the first loop where is exist on this line or not. So theta equal to 0. So we put theta equal to 0 in the equation here. Theta equal to 0, then cos 0, that is 1, r equal to a. R equal to a, that means r is the distance here. R is the distance from origin to the loop. This is the length of the loop. So here here we obtained this first loop on theta equal to 0, r equal to a. That means here is your first loop on the this theta equal to 0 line. Okay, now the first loop is clear here. Now what about here? We have to trace total how many loops? We have to trace the total 4 loops. The 4 loops, first loop position is clear. This is on theta equal to 0 line. This is r equal to a distance. So first loop on this angle theta equal to 0 for cos 2 theta. Okay. Now remaining three loops we have to trace. So where is the second loop? This is the first loop position. This is first loop position on theta equal to 0. Now then where is the next loop position? The next loop position is on the 4n upon lp. See here, 4n upon lp. This showing the next loop position. So next loop position 4n upon lp. So n is 2, lp is number of loops. This is 4. Just we are putting the value of n and lp. And 4 becomes cancelled. So here we obtain the next loop position. Next loop position. So here what is the next loop position here? Next loop exists on the second line. So how to count the second line? How we find here which is the second line? See, yeah. See, it is the first loop. Okay, this is the clear. This is the first loop on theta equal to 0. So where is the second line? So see here, see the how to count the second line. Where is the second line? See, this is the loop. Now is the next. We start from here. Counting start from here. So the second line. So 1, 2. So next loop position. See here, next loop on. Next loop on this second line. So next loop on second line. So counting is start from here. 1, 2. This is the second line. This second line is here. So the next loop is the on the second line. Now again, how many loops we have to trace? Total 4. And here we trace 1 and 2. Okay, now we have to trace the third loop. Again, we counting start till here. So count again from here. First, second line. So where is the next loop? On the second line. So 1, 2. Means how we are counting this like this. See, this is the first loop. 1, 2. Here is loop. 1, 2. Here is loop. 1, 2. Here is loop. 1, 2, here is loop. So how you are counting this second? Where is the next loop position? The next loop position is that is on the second line. Okay. So to tracing the rose curve, we clear here about the petals and lines. Okay. So now here is this. Is clear and how to write this angle. See here, how to write the angles here. Theta equal to 0. Theta equal to 0. Here 1 pi by 4, 2 pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, 4 pi by 4, 5 pi by 4, 6 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4. Or here is 8 pi by 4. This is by mistake is written. This is 8 pi by 4 becomes 2 pi. Here in the next example, there is I am written clearly 8 pi by 4. Okay. So in the previous example, just number of lines, how many petals are there, how many petals means loops are there, and then the next loops are position. Now see the next question here. If tracing the curve r equal to a sine 2 theta, r equal to a sine 2 theta. So here first what about n? First, we clear about n, because n is from n we are getting the number of loops and lines. Okay, so how many? What is n here? N is 2. N is 2. So number of lines in each quadrant, n minus 1. This is the fix. Okay, how many lines is 2 minus 1? This is 1. Now these lines we have to trace in this quadrant. In each quadrant, hai na? We have 4 quadrants. So we have to trace these lines. In each quadrant, we are tracing one line. How many lines we are tracing in each quadrant? N minus 1. How many lines we are tracing in each quadrant? N minus 1. Now, what is the angle between these lines? Because if we are tracing the lines, then we should know about the angle between these lines, or what is the distance between the lines. Okay, so here is the number of lines in each quadrant, that is in each quadrant one line. Okay, and then we see here ki angle between these lines including axis, then what is the angle? Pi by 2 upon n. Then pi by 2 upon n means n that is given in the question. N is given in the question, that is pi by 4. Okay, now we find the number of loops. Number of loops means number of petals, because we are thinking about the rose curve again and again. We are thinking about rose tracing means we are thinking about rose flower. Rose flowers require rose here petals, and that's why now we find the number of petals means number of loops. So here our thinking if change regarding question, then obviously our thinking is changed about the solution. So if this understanding becomes easy, so here number of loops means number of petals of the rose flower. So number of loops, that is twice n, because of 2 is even number. So for even number, this is 4. Okay, so now we start to trace the loops. These 4 loops we have to trace. So one by one we have to trace. So what is the first loop position? Then we trace the remaining loops. Okay, so what is the first loop? The first loop, how we have to trace the first loop? The first loop, where is the first loop? The first loop on the line which is next to theta equal to 0 line. Because if we put theta equal to 0, because we are starting the thinking from here, theta equal to 0, then this, then for this first initially theta equal to 0, then what is the, where is the position of first loop if theta equal to 0? So see here, if theta equal to 0, we put in this equation. If theta equal to 0, okay, so if theta equal to 0, then r equal to a sine 2 theta. Okay, this is given equation, and here is theta is 0, then sine 2 into 0, sine 0 means sine 0 degree means 0, a into 0 becomes 0. So r is 0 means what is this? This is the distance from origin to the loop. So on at which angle? At theta equal to 0. That means there does not exist any loop at this angle. For this angle theta equal to 0, there does not exist any loop for this theta equal to 0. R is 0. Now the first loop position, then where is the first loop position? So it's a next line. Lines we drawn already in previous steps, you know, in step 1 and step 2 we already traced the lines. So where is the position of the first loop? So it is clear if first loop does not exist on the x-axis. First loop does not exist on the x-axis means does not exist on theta equal to 0 line. So where is the first loop? The first loop, it's a next line. There exists the first loop for sine. So first loop there exists after this coming line. This is the first line. So here we have to trace the first loop. So here first loop position is fixed. And now we have to find the position of the remaining three loops. So first loop is clear here. Now the next loop position. The next loop position formula is 4n upon LP. 4n upon LP. So n is given in the question, that is 2. LP is 4. 4, 4 becomes cancel. And here we get the second line. What is the position for next loop? That is the second line. Then how we count the second line? Second line, see here we in previously we discussed. Here is the first loop. Okay. If it is first loop, then we from here we count the second line. How to count the second line? Here is first loop. So after this here, we start the counting. Where from where we start the counting? After this line we have to start the counting. So here is second line. So count here 1, 2, first, second. So again there is loop. Though there we get here second line, we draw the loop. So here is second line, draw loop. Here first and second, we draw the loops. Then here 1 and 2, then here we trace the loops again 1, 2. So just we counting like this, second line for the, here we trace the next loop for the second line. Okay, so this diagram or this stretching for was for this r equal to a sin 2 theta. Okay, so here we trace, it's a previous example, this was the r equal to a cos 2 theta and here is r equal to a sin 2 theta. So this is the, what is the difference between this and this? Here the first loop on this axis, because cos 0 is 1. So if we put here r equal to a, but here is r equal to 0 for this theta equal to 0 line. So here distance from the curve, distance to the curve of that is r equal to 0. That's why here is 0. Now the next example, see here. Here we solve this previous first and second example for even numbers. Okay, so now the next is for 3. If 3 is odd number. So if 3 is odd number, now the what will be the values of this? Okay, lines and number of petals. Okay, so here similarly we find number of lines, angles and number of loops. Where is the first position for the first loop, then remaining
Hello everyone, myself Sanskar Maskam. I'm very sorry that we have lost the connection with Datta sir. Hope we are gonna connect with him in as soon as possible ways. I'm really sorry for that. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Sanskar Maske, coordinator of this webinar. I deemed it a great honor to propose a vote of thanks to all who have helped us in making the webinar such a resounding success. First of all, I would like to thank our chief guest, Dr. Abhishek Datta, for gracing today's webinar. During the webinar, we have gained a good knowledge of tracing of curves. I would like to express our profound gratitude to our principal, Dr. R.N. Patil, for providing platform for this webinar and making wide publicity of this webinar. I would like to thank our distinguished co-speaker, Professor Jyoti Dhanke, for making excellent presentations and making this webinar interesting and meaningful. I would also like to thank our beloved HODs for their kind support. I thank to all the 1800 participants for making the webinar a grand success. I would like to thank our webinar team who have performed a lot of things. Once again, I thank all of you for your kind cooperation and patience. Thank you.